This video provides an overview of the G9250AA Pesticides and Environmental Pollutants MRM database. It is highly recommended that you make a backup copy of the database. In this video, you will be introduced to the content and layout of the database, which is in Excel format for easy searching and sorting. The Database tab is displayed when you first open the database. Let's go over the other tabs in this database. MRM table is used to build the MRM acquisition method. Database compound list has all the names and CAS numbers of the compounds in this database. My target compound list is a list of compounds that you would like to build an acquisition method from. The next three tabs are three methods used in this database: two constant flow methods and one constant pressure method. Each tab gives you the detailed method parameters. The last tab, What is VLOOKUP, shows the Excel function VLOOKUP, which will be discussed in a separate method building video. When you open the database, you should make sure that the filtering function is turned on by pressing this button. There are over 1,000 compounds in this database. They are separated by color bands, green, white, green, and so on. Each band has multiple rows that represent multiple MRM transitions for that compound. This allows us to work around matrix interferences by using different MRM transitions. Let's go over the different columns in the Database tab. The first one is the common name of each compound. Next column is the molecular formula. The next one is average molecular weight. Next is the monoisotopic or exact molecular weight. The next column is the CAS number. This CAS number column does not have dashes for sorting purpose. The next two columns are the classifications of each compound. Here are some examples in classification 1. Fungicide, herbicide, pollutant. And here are some examples in classification 2. Benzamide, fumigant, PCB, semi-volatile, The next six columns are retention times and retention indices from the three methods listed in the three tabs below. Constant flow 40-minute method, constant pressure 40-minute method, and constant flow 20-minute method. Within a method, injection modes, that is split, splitless, or large volume injection, can vary analyte retention times. These two columns are the retention times and retention indices for the constant flow 40-minute method. These two are the constant pressure 40-minute method. These two are the constant flow 20-minute method. This table is currently sorted according to the retention times of this method. The next column is the user field, which you can use to pull out compounds from the database you want to analyze based on a specific method or a project. Currently, we have AAA method, Lab302 method, and toxic congener method in this column. Let's just select two of the three methods and see what we get. Now, the database shows just the Lab302 method and the toxic congener method. You can use this filtering function to quickly select a method to build an acquisition method based on the compounds in the method selected. Let's select all of them back and continue to discuss the other columns in this database. These highlighted columns have all the information needed to build a Mass Hunter MRM acquisition method. CAS numbers have dashes now. Common name again. Due to the Mass Hunter requirements, no special characters or Greek letters are allowed in this common name column. This column is the retention times of the method that you are going to use. Is this compound an internal standard, true or false? This column shows the precursor ion, the MS1 resolution. Low res is the same as wide setting in the Mass Hunter acquisition method. This column shows the product ion, the MS2 resolution, dwell time in milliseconds, collision energy, and retention time window. This retention time window is used to set up time segments in the acquisition method. The next column shows the response of each individual transition and how it scaled among all transitions in this database. The number in each cell is a reference value. This column is color scaled, where red or orange indicates a higher value, while blue or dark blue indicates a lower value. By glancing at the different colors in this column, you can quickly tell that some of the transitions are more responsive and some are less responsive. The next column shows the relative intensity of each transition within a compound. The first one is 100% for picoline 2. This is the highest response among the seven transitions. Next one, 57%, is the response of this transition relative to the highest response. 51%, 42%, and so on. You can use this column to quickly find out the significance of each transition. Based on the relative responses, we label all transitions as Q0, Q1, Q2, and so on. Q0 is usually used for quantitation. In this example, you have seven transitions for picoline to work around matrix interferences. The next column is another user field. We will demonstrate how you can take advantage of this user field column in the MRM acquisition method video. The last three columns are Chinese name, Japanese name, and the group number for the Chinese National Pesticide method. The Chinese National method separates 550 pesticides into six groups from A to F. When applicable, the database has Chinese name, Japanese name, and the group number of the Chinese National method for each compound. We can use the filtering function to select, for example, only Group C compounds. The database can quickly filter it out for you. You can then build an acquisition method for just Group C compounds.